In the investigation that has Bardstown talking and interstate wide. After a day of searching by a huge team of federal and state police, no arrests tonight in the 5-year-long disappearance of Crystal Rogers, one of Bardstown's biggest unsolved mysteries. The night team's Jesse Cohen was there as the FBI worked late at one of three locations. The homes of Nick Houck, Brooks Houck, and the Houck family farm all searched in the hunt for more evidence.
9 search warrants have been served by the FBI today, who are now the lead investigators in the disappearance of Crystal Rogers. One of those was to Nick Houck's house right behind me here in Bardstown, where they spent more than 13 hours digging through his property.
Rummaging through his car and digging through the house, that's the last action we saw from the FBI at the house of former Bardstown police officer Nick Houck just a few hours ago.
Sleeping in bed, my husband heard a big boom.
Ashley Mudd lives just a few doors down from Nick, and her husband heard the noise early this morning.
I knew exactly what they were doing, where they were at, and been waiting for it.
We never saw Nick go back inside his house when the FBI was done for today, but just a few miles away, his brother Brooks, named the chief suspect in the case, hopped on his mower to mow his front lawn just as the FBI left. This was a very different image than hours before when the commotion began. From guns to file cabinets and stacks of documents, they spent hours taking things from the two properties.
They're going through everything.
While dozens of other members of the response team were at the Houck family farm, which is just a few miles away from where human remains were found less than 2 weeks ago.
You never expect it to be hit home, but sometimes it does.
A property owner whose land is just feet away from where they were discovered took us to the spot. That hole in the embankment of the creek is where they found the unidentified human remains. But he says if it weren't for Mother Nature, they may have never been found.
Where we're standing right now on June 29th was probably 12 feet of water.
He says record rainfall over the last 3 years has eroded this area 10 or 12 feet. Now knowing someone has been buried here hits close to home.
It'd be nice to know what happened, just to know and just have closure, especially for the family, whosever family it is. That would be the main thing. No, it's just a peaceful little community.
To be clear, those human remains that were found have not been identified, and there is no timeline on when they will be. But people in the community that we spoke with today say they hope searches like those at Nick's house here will lead to more answers in the disappearance of Crystal Rogers. In Bardstown, for the night team, I'm Jesse Cohen.